we are going to see the push and pop operations of using in stack using the linked list data structure. So here what we are going to do is, we are first imagine initially the stack is empty. Now we are going to add data. So how you can add data? So first we create a temporary node. So first initially let us imagine this is the node. Imagine these things are all not there. Only this thing is there. That is how it will be there. Means temp equal to new node. By creating a node, we have declared a temporary pointer which is subtype node, and then in using that pointer we create a node structure by using the operator new. So after doing this, this node will be created. Now in that data field we place the data. Suppose imagine we want to place some data file. So in this push you will be passing the value 5 here. So when you call this push 5, now this will be added. This in the data portion, this data, this value will be placed. And then in temp next top, initially top is since when top is equal to null means there is an empty list. So initially top is made to null. So now when creation of this, temp is pointing to this and top is already it is equal to null. So now that null is allocated here. Okay, now temp next, in temp next the top, what is the top? It is null. So that is allocated. Then top now becomes temp. Now top is made to point this temp, which is nothing but this node. So top is equal to temp mean now it is made to point, which is nothing but 100. This is, that is, but these are the memory locations. This is a memory location which this node is created. So now top is made to point to this memory location 100. Now we now imagine, now you are pushing another data, say for example some 10. So with the value 10, now what happens again? The new node will be created. Let us imagine this is the new node. Now what happens? This data will be returned, which is nothing but our value 10. Now after doing this, the next step, now this is a temp. Now according to this, this is the temp now. Okay, now the temp is pointing this. So what happens? Yes, now temp is pointing this. So in temp beta we have returned the value 10, and then in temp next, temp next is nothing but this. In this you write the top. What is the top value? It is 100. So now this 100 is written here. So this 100 is written here in this location. Now again let us imagine we are passing some 50, push 50. So in that case what happened? Now it again creates a node called temp, which is nothing but, now this is our temporary node. Here these two are attached by this. So after this and here the top is made to point this. Okay, now top is pointing this. Temp next we put the top pointer which is pointed earlier, and then top is made to point to this step. Now push 50. Now what happens? Again a new node is created and we call it as a temp, and in that we write the value 50. Okay, then in temp next, this is what temp. In temp next you put the top value. What is top now pointing? It is nothing but 102. That is a memory location. So you place that value here in temp next. In doing so you make this to point to this. Then this is has to be made as top. So now top has become this. Both temp and top are pointing to this. Okay, so when again some more data is there, temp is used to create the new node and used to point, and then once the temp node is attached to that, the top will be made to point to the temporary node, because you push always whatever you put data, that will be become the first value. So this will be the first value to be inserted. After that you insert the value 10, so that will become the latest, that will be the top of the stack, and then you insert another. Now the top pointer is moved to point to this. So now top is pointing this. and all are connected by with the next field, they are all connected. So after this, this is 102, after this 100, and so on. Now we'll say pop. So popping is popping from the top. After you pop this, now this will become the top. So how it has been done? Through programmatically. That is what we are going to see now. Here, see the pop. Then we declare a temporary variable called del data, which will hold that deleted data. Then here we declare a temporary pointer. Then we check anything to be popped. First, we have to check whether any element is there. So we check whether is empty is equal to 1 or not. If it is not equal to 1, which means the stack is not empty. It has some value. So now we can delete. So here, before deleting, we assign the value. So for example, I'm going to pop the top element. So 20, this is the value. So the top data, top is this and top data is this. So that is allocated to the temporary variable. Now what we do is, this temp we assign to this top. Now this temporary pointer is assigned to this. Then we make the top to point to the next location. So how it is done? Top equal to top next. This is top. Top next is nothing but. So now top becomes pointing to this. So it is decremented. Now this is no more accessible, because you can strictly access the data only using the top pointer. So now the pointer itself is moved and this is disconnected. And but it has been connected with the pointer called temp. So now the way we are doing that, we have to remove it completely from the memory. That is why we are assigning it to a temporary pointer. Then the popped element we print, because we have already stored that value which is stored in the node, which we have already stored in a variable. So that we print, and then we give delete temp. In that case, the memory occupied by this node will be released. Else, if it is equal to 0, if it returns a 1, then means the stack is empty and we cannot remove anything. So this message will be printed.